Now, in case you're wondering about this win-loss record so far in the tournament, of course, to the start of the tournament, 40 men singles players divided into 16 groups, which of course meant that 8 of the groups only had 2 men in. So in essence, a straight knockout for Lee Chong Wei, only one match within his group, and that was against Villa Lang from Finland. As you can see, needed 3 games there, got the second game 14-21 before coming back 21-11 in the decider. And then against the number 9 seed, Simon Santoso of Indonesia, looked very, very impressive. 21-12, 21-8 in just 36 minutes. Well, Kashyap Parupalli had to play 2 matches in his group. And what a big surprise when he defeated the number 10 seed, Tian Min Yun from Vietnam, in 2 straight games as well. His last 16 match was against Niluka Karunanratne of Sri Lanka. 1 hour and 6 minutes he battled through that, 21-9 in the deciding game. And of course, Karunanratne had put out the number 8 seed, Kenichi Togo of Japan. So Kashyap Parupalli in the quarterfinal, what an occasion for him. Until the very last tournament in the qualifying period, which was his home event, the Indian Super Series event, he didn't think he was going to qualify. In the quarterfinal in Delhi, he was given a walkover by Chen Jin of China, and that semi-final place took him above his teammate AJ Jayaram to be the sole representative of India in the men's singles. Well, Lee Chong Wei has battled his way back from injury problems. You can see that right ankle heavily strapped. Went down against Denmark's Peter Gaeder at the Thomas Cup Finals in Wuhan. And he's been battling that injury ever since to get back in time for these Olympic Games.
On the right, Lee Chong Wei, Malaysia. Kashyap Parupalli, India. Kashyap Parupalli to serve. Labor. Play.
So umpire Ivo Kassel from Switzerland getting this men's singles quarterfinal underway. History being made today with Kashyap Parupalli of India, the far side of the court as we look down in the quarterfinal of the men's singles. First Indian male player to achieve that status, but my goodness, he wants to go one better at least. Main quarterfinal, but he's up against the number 1 seed, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia. Oh, that's delightful. Now this is the second meeting between these two men. The previous time they've played each other was in the first round of the Denmark Super Series event last year. 2 straight games, Lee Chong Wei won on that occasion, 21-11, 21-13. So really pretty comfortable. Another good angle from Kashyap Parupalli.
2-1.
Born in Mumbai, but now based in Hyderabad at the Gopi Chand Academy. Leonard Gopi Chand, one of his coaches here, head coach, in fact, to the Indian badminton team. Oh, it's been a good start. Kashyap. Long, long rallies in his last 16 encounter against Miluka Karunaratne. Perfect net shots. Hits the top of the tape. Trickles over. And a 4-1 advantage. Good judgment. It's gone wide. Wide, good judgment. And that run of five straight points comes to an end, much to the relief, I'm sure, of Malaysian fans. Of age now, Lee Chong Wei, born in Georgetown, Penang. His opponent just 25. Just wide. Thoughts when Lee Chong Wei beat the number 9 seed Santoso of Indonesia. I thought his speed of movement around the court and the way he took the game to his opponent, dictating the pace, commanding the rallies, was some of the best badminton I've ever seen Lee Chong Wei play. Good smash. Sent a message to the rest of the world, Kashyap Parupalli, when he defeated the number 1 seed Chen Long in the second round of the Indonesia Super Series events just a couple of months ago. Lee Chong Wei in that rally sending a message to his opponent. A good return of serve. And the lack of reaction from Lee Chong Wei to me is a sign that he's nervous. Who's taking all the initiative in the rallies. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Well, that very, very reminiscent of his last 16 match. The reverse slice, straight drop, and immediately forward so quickly. Indian coaches. Gopachan on the right as we looked at them, and Edwin Indrawan. Oh no, he's missed it. Over anxious to get to the mid game interval with the advantage. Chong Wei and the rest of the Malaysian badminton team had a training camp at Bath University prior to the start of these Olympic Games. By all accounts, he was looking very impressive in training. Totally outmaneuvered. A tight net shot. Pushed him to the back. There's the push once again. Comes in, waits for the drop back to the net, and a delicate little block to finish off the rally. Closed the deficit to just 2 points. The fault? He has indeed. Ivo Kessel calls a fault, says that he struck the shuttle before it had crossed over the net. Well, we're not going to see from that, unfortunately. Well, I don't speak Bahasa, but oh, in fact, yeah, I've been speaking Chinese there, but from his gestures, I would guess that he was saying, come on, you've got to play with a little more urgency at the moment. You're just playing little blocks, force it a bit more, take it a little bit earlier, move those feet, get the feet moving quickly. I wonder if we'll see him up the pace after this mid-game interval. But all credit to Kashyap Parupalli. Started this quarter-final encounter in very positive fashion. So Parupalli resumes play. That is brilliant. Great disguise. huge contingent of the Malaysian team here to support Lee Chong Wei. Superb. Absolutely wonderful. Bided his time until he had the right opportunity to go for the winner. 11-12. Dropped down from world number one, Lee Chong Wei, 2 or 3 weeks ago. Been world number one since the 21st of August 2008. Done from Parupalli. Had the most remarkable run, Lee Chong Wei, over 2010, 2011. Reached the final of every single tournament he participated in for 17 consecutive tournaments. Over a 14-month period. Just sense perhaps a shift in momentum. Good. Threatening the net area, he was ready to pounce, and that forced Kashyap Parupalli into error. Yeah, court needing to be mopped of the perspiration, therefore the players take the opportunity to have a little timeout. Well, nobody should underestimate this man, Kashyap. Saying he's beaten Chen Long, who's the number three seed here at the Olympic Games. He's also beaten the likes of Lee Hyun-il. Lee Hyun-il was fourth at the last Olympic Games. What a finalist this year too. So 1 point the deficit. Thank you. Well, now he's called a fault on Kashyap Parupalli. Not allowed to strike the shuttle before the shuttle has crossed over the line of the net. And not allowed to touch the net either. Short. Miss hits, but it had the desired effect. Shot. And again. Mixing up the pace of his attacking shots, he's hit a couple of really powerful smashes, that time slicing across the feathers. Means the shuttle travels much slower. Comes down much steeper. Such a big point too. Oh, he's overdone it. It's not often I say that Yu Chong Wei has run out of patience. The court to be mopped while he's having a tell down. Yeah. 20 minutes of play so far. Judgment makes it drop long. I have to say, so far in the match, well, Kashyap Parupalli has done about neutralizing the attacking play of Yu Chong Wei. Crunch time now, though, in this opening game. Broken the strings of his racket, has he with that? No, maybe not. It sounded very odd. here. It was the tight spinning net shot that did the damage. Oh, that was brave to leave that. And your opponent is sprawled on the floor. I think I would have had a tendency just to play the winner anyway. And good courage from Lee Chong Wei. Level once again. Overdone it on the clear. And Kashyap Parupalli just managing to stay in front. Oh, that error could prove costly. So too could that. Unseeded player from India. Now just 2 points away from this opening game. Oh, that is just glorious. Leapt in the air. Looked as if he was going to play the power smash. Parupalli very, very deep in his base position, waiting for the power shot, and therefore leaving himself very vulnerable to the disguised drop shot. Level once more. Oh, that was going out. Well, a valiant effort by Kashyap Parupalli, diving to retrieve the shot. It hit the top of the tape, but it fell back his side. And therefore, the number one seed, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia, has a game point. And what with the dive, caught Moppers on. Because the perspiration from the player's shirts get left on the court surface, and then the court can become a little bit slippery. And you've got to get the court attendant on. Perspiration dripping from both players. Warm conditions here at Wembley Arena. Game point. Good lift. In the opening game, having trailed for virtually its entirety, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia comes good at exactly the right moment. Well, The umpire confirming the score. And I should think Lee Chong Wei nicely relieved to squeeze through that opening game. Final put away, 21-19. 27 minutes of play. Well, both players and both their coaches. Large Malaysian contingent here. Road to London 2012. Datuk Lee Chong Wei. Lee Chong Wei has awarded a Datuk chip from the governor of Penang. Equivalent to somebody here in the UK being called Sir. I'd be fascinated to know what Colonel Gopichand, the Indian coach, said to his man, Kashyap Parupalli. And psychologically, a little crushing that had been ahead for so long in that opening game, and then missed out in the end. Tactically, I think Kashyap was playing very, very well. Seed Lee Chong Wei having secured that opening game, 21-19. Well, it's quite obvious the silver medalist from 4 years ago cannot afford to relax at all, because Kashyap is ready to pounce. Fabulous. Lee Chong Wei, of course, Commonwealth Games gold medalist for the last two Commonwealth Games, Asian Games silver medalist, World Championship silver medalist, and Olympic silver medalist. And he's been talking about how a gold medal here in London would validate his career. And I think he's had a great career anyway. 42 career titles, 25 of them Super Series. And when you think Lin Dan's only won 17 Super Series, that's an indication of how good this man and how consistent he's been for so many years. And sadly, so many people judge by Olympic gold medals. Yep, plum on the line. Oh, brilliant. First real use of the body smash. And he played it to perfection, because he had smashed first of all straight down the line, in at the body. Discussion back in Malaysia about whether Lee Chong Wei should have been the flag bearer for the opening ceremony. One of their top female divers was given that honour. And Lee Chong Wei, very diplomatic as always, and said how much he thought that she deserved the honour. Moved his base half a yard further forward in court as Lee Chong Wei from that far side of the court. Stepping in, taking the drop shots and nut shots much, much earlier. In fact, encroaching in too far on that occasion. There's also a sideways drift in this arena. Left to right as we look down on the court. Kashyap Parupalli has to be very, very careful here. He doesn't allow the Malaysian to get too much of a lead. Oh, that's wonderful play. With his smash. Now 5-point advantage. Well, it's called out. Little look from Lee Chong Wei to the umpire as if to appeal for an overall. No verbal request though. I think he was right to try and threaten the nets. Kashyap. That's drifted by that clear indication of the drift. Chong Wei looking very much more relaxed right now. Again, an 11-6 up. Chand, taller of the two coaches, seemed to be urging his man to bring his base a little bit further forward, certainly on defensive play. I think that's a wise thing. Sign, thankfully, of either his ankle injury or his shoulder injury. His shoulder injury forced him to withdraw halfway through the All England final earlier this year. Just missed it. Title Kashyap Parupalli. He's had a good year so far, three semi-finals. Oh, that is just a classic shot from Li Chong Wei. As far as Kashyap Parupalli is concerned. Got a claw back this 7-point advantage held by Li Chong Wei. He's running out of ideas. That was desperation. Wasn't on balance. Trying to force the issue. What he did so well in the opening game was to work Li Chong Wei. Work until he got an opening, got him out of position, and then he went for his winner. wholeness. A backhand smash from Li Chongwei, played to absolute perfection. Well, he appears to be on cruise control now. Performance here in the second game. Nine of 11 points played since his 10-6 lead. Suspects. Kashyap Parupalli really came into this tournament under the radar. Oh my goodness, hasn't he performed above expectations? Defeating the number 10 seed, Tian Minh Nguyen of Vietnam in the group. And then coming his through to this quarterfinal. But it'll take something exceptional. Because Li Chongwei is on the verge of victory. 10 match point opportunities. Yeah, well worked, well saved by Kashyap Parupalli. Time of asking, and Li Chongwei, the number one seed, is through to the semi-final. The Olympic silver medalist from 4 years ago turns to his fans and his supporters, a big sigh of relief as much as elation. Thanks the crowd for their support, and having been down for so long in that opening game, came back to sneak it in the end. Second game, much more straightforward. Thanks the court officials. This, the final rally. Relief, delight. And a semi-final awaits. 47 minutes, 21-19, 21-11. Longest rally, 41 strokes, and that was in the opening game.